Judging by the channels that you guys seem to watch, I need to open up a coding conversion therapy to get all you guys from scratch to Gamemaker Studio 2, the objectively best game engine. Why is it the best game engine? Because it's the one I use. And why do I use it? Because it's the one I use. But because I have over a year of experience in this theme, I don't really know what it feels like to be a new user. So to help put myself in your guys' shoes, I will be doing a tutorial, and then, free of charge, I'll be helping you guys improve on the tutorial. Now, there are many tutorials available on the GameMaker website. I'm not sponsored, but my word does come cheap, so GameMaker, hit me up. And going through, there are quite a few good ones, including this one here, made for Unity users migrating to GameMaker. And before you ask, this was posted the day after they lost all credibility. Now, the first one that I found was this tutorial on an included game called Woody Woods. It's just a simple platform, and my problem with it is that it's just a tutorial in using the GameMaker interface, mainly looking around rooms and placing objects. And whilst that is great for anyone starting out with the engine, it isn't something that you can make a video out of. So, I settled on this one here on platformer movement, and I'll be following this to the T, so let's get to it! The first step in getting character movement is getting the character in. Luckily, GameMaker has an easy way of doing this. They get you to download the sprites from the tutorial, and you just drag it into your project. It recognizes what things are what, and you just press import. This tutorial comes with a player sprite, ground, and a slope, which is all that's needed for this. The tutorial then goes over collision masks or hitboxes, explaining what each one is, although the important ones for this are rectangle, what you want for your ground, ellipse for some reason, and precise, which makes the hitbox an exact match of the sprite. There's also precise per frame, which gets the hitbox to change every frame, but that's not required for most themes. Next, the tutorial sets up a few variables, one for movement speed and one for jump height. These are ones that you'd probably want to get used to adding, no matter what type of project you do, because it just makes changing everything easy. You just have to change these variables instead of changing every instance of it. But then GameMaker adds in two more variables called move X and move Y. These are a bit useful, but they already have things that I would think would be better in GameMaker, but this isn't my tutorial. That's coming when I feel like making one. After that, the tutorial covers the stuff in the step event. This is what runs every frame, so movement is sort of kind of made for this sort of stuff. Now, this code here is pretty basic, although I have one complaint with this. It uses the arrow keys instead of A and D. It's not difficult to just have ORD A and ORD D, Mr. or Mrs. GameMaker, and it's so much more natural. Anyway, I put in the stuff for movement and jump in, and seeing as how the basic code seems complete, I load it up.
And this is where I messed up. You see, how I test and write my code is I use the X and Y variables and add to them, or set the H speed and V speed variables. So I instinctively load it up to test that it worked, and...
Hold on. This goes against... Oh. Typical...
That happened. Now, what was the issue? I didn't follow the tutorial. There were a few steps that were after it. So, make sure to read the tutorials, kiddos. Now that I'm out here, I need your help. I'm currently in a sub-race to 1,000 subscribers with Zendark Apps. I currently have a pretty good lead, but it's starting to catch up. So if you could subscribe, that would be greatly appreciated. Anyway, let's get back to me failing at a basic tutorial.
Once I realized what the problem was, I followed the tutorial with its collision code that I didn't know existed. I'd have to put that into some of my stuff to see how it works because it looks interesting, especially considering how I currently do collisions. And after actually following the tutorial, I can move. This is a simple scene that I was told to set up in the tutorial featuring ground, weird pig thing, one tile high ground, two tile high ground, and of course, sloped platform. Now, the pig runs around this thing just fine. There are two issues that this platform movement has, though. One is that the animation doesn't change when you change directions, and the other is when you try to go down a slope, this stuff happens, so let's fix that up. Following the tutorial, obviously, because free will is for suckers. The code used is pretty simple. Now, it's here that I noticed an issue that GameMaker didn't. See this code here? It uses it to choose which way the creature faces. But when going down a slope, this variable equals zero, meaning it doesn't change, causing the X scale to stay the same way. Sure, it's not a problem when going down unless you change direction,
and then you're walking backwards. But this is a simple tutorial. Anyone making a full game would have their own way of fixing this up, so I'll leave it be as much as it annoys me. And now the tutorial gets confusing. Now I guess that it wants you to change the sprite in the object, but that doesn't work for many reasons, mainly because the image here has both sloped and non-sloped platforms. So it's time for Fruit Toast's fixes to Gamemaker Tutorials. Create a new object called object underscore slope. Put the sprite in, go to this tab here and add the platform as a parent. It'll now be considered the same object as the platform and you can walk up it. And that's all for this episode of Fruit Toast's fixes to Gamemaker Tutorials. See you next episode where I- Oh come on! Yeah, it gets you to do the same thing here. So what you want to do is create a new object called object underscore invisible wall, put the sprite in, go to this tab here and add platform as a parent. Then you want to click this visible box here. And that's all for this episode of Fruit Toast's fixes to Gamemaker Tutorials. Make sure to take that subscribe button hostage and shoot its family. And I'll see you next time.
Now with the basic platform movement done featuring my patent pending in between steps that Gamemaker forgot, I decided to fix up a couple issues that I had with the rest of the code, and by a couple, I mean one regarding some light stuff because I couldn't get anything else to work.
So let's improve this code in two ways, but only one because I couldn't figure one of them out. Now my main problem with this stuff is the controls. Whenever I make a game that's controlled with a keyboard and mouse, I use WASD because I'm not left-handed. No one is, they are all lying. But this is a problem I see a lot in tutorials, not just this one. No one uses the arrow keys for movement in any good game. Everything first person uses WASD, and most platforms on Steam use WASD. So let's fix this up. What I've started doing movement is I make a begin step event. This one's before the step event, so it's good for this sort of stuff, especially if it's likely to be used by multiple objects, and add in this code here. It looks long, but all it's saying is if left arrow key A or the left D-pad button on a controller is being held down, left equals 1. And then I just copy and paste that in for the right with a couple changes, and jumping is the same again. And that's improved movement. You can move with WASD or A and D, arrow keys, and controller. Now you just have to change these to the variable set in here, making sure to add an else statement that sets the variables to 0 when no buttons are being pressed. Then I tried to fix the slope issue, but after multiple attempted solutions, I couldn't do it. If I'd given myself any time at all to do this, I'd have a solution. But it's a tutorial made for people with about 17 seconds of game maker experience, so I'll leave it be. And this is what the game looks like in the end. I added a few platforms, although I can't reach them because of that piss poor jump height.
Now that's what a game made the way GameMaker intended looks like. Sure, I did notice another bug whilst reviewing the footage. He is not stopping moving. But that's just two lines of code that I'm too lazy to add right now. Now, if you like this video, I'd recommend checking out this video here where I overhauled the enemy AI in my upcoming game, Tempest Island. And make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.